growing at 5 or 7% today is the equivalent in absolute value of 10 to 12% 5 years ago. So thinking that China has a problem growing at 5 or 7%, I don't understand. China is still a growing market, and 7% growth in China could be compared with 2 to 3% growth in America. And we are very happy when America grows at 2 to 3%. So, no, I'm very, very confident. The stabilization period was necessary after such a growth.
Are you slowing, though, new store openings in China this year?
The point is that on a net basis, openings, closings, it will slow down. The reason being, for instance, for Gucci, that one specific phenomenon in China is the fact that the city geography in terms of commerce is not stabilized, meaning that a good location 3 years ago might not be so good 3 years after, which is not the case anywhere else in the world. So we need to be very flexible
the
to make sure.
The Champs-Élysées is the Champs-Élysées.
Exactly. Fifth Avenue is Fifth Avenue.
Yeah, right.
Shanghai, Beijing is completely different. So you need to integrate that in the way you do business. And we decided to cope with that for, it's been a year and a half now, to make sure that we always have the best network of stores in that country. So we are now relocating some stores, changing malls when it's necessary. So you need to make sure that you are in the right place at the right moment.
Globally, what can you reveal to us on how you are going to restore the momentum for Gucci? The fourth quarter, as you know, the weakest sales growth since the third quarter of 2009. That was an exceptional year, 2009, as the global financial crisis was happening. What's happening now with Gucci, and how are you going to right whatever is going wrong, if it's going wrong?
No. We are in the middle of the implementation of the strategy, which is, and it's all the big brands have the same challenge. How do you remain exclusive and on the same time continue to grow? This is some schizophrenic situation there. We don't believe that luxury brands can take advantage of all the price segment by stretching the brand vertically, like very low price, 200 euros towards 5,000 euros in the same category. We don't believe in that. So we need to move upwards as the number of customers capable of buying luxury products is increasing in the world. This has an impact on sales, but that's absolutely what we wanted to do. So I'm not at all, I know that the financial market have some question about the slowing growth of Gucci. It's what we want. If the growth was based on selling more and more, we would please everyone. But this will be the greatest danger for the brand. So it's very important that we move upwards.
How about on the other end of the spectrum, where are you in the transformation of Puma in lifestyle and sports? It sounds like this year, perhaps next year as well, is the make or break year for Puma.
Yeah, first sign, end of this year for sure.
Okay.
So we will know. Implementation, execution of the strategy is the other key. And this is what we missed over the last 4 years at Puma, and then I'm pretty sure that we will correct that.
You can grab some of that market share from Nike and Adidas, the much bigger players.
The market is growing, so I will get market share from other players for sure, but the market is growing. This is very important. Luxury and sports are structurally, over the long period of time, growing markets. So this is why the group has this very strong potential worldwide.